I don't like to speak about the crisis anymore, but there has been an economic stagnation for several years now, and this of course affects many of the local developments and many of the plans that have been changing over the time on the island. We have been doing, in the past years, many focus group interviews with several stakeholder groups on the island that were very useful for generating data or on what are the challenges, what are the visions on the island. But those have been also very nice opportunities for the groups themselves to experience a different kind of visionary communication. And this, I believe, helped also in developing a local association that we're going to be here about this afternoon, called Sustainable Samothraki, that are now again involved back into the research as citizen scientists. So there has been this kind of feedback loop, if you want. And the same idea has been in our minds for the summer school as well, so for in the past and also for this one. So the idea is to combine different things. One is, of course, teaching. We implement different methods, different sociological and aquatic ecological methods.
Scientists of ECMA has been focusing on samothraki water resources for about 17 years. In the head of national and international projects, master and PhD thesis. Also, we established the Samothraki Nature Observatory. And
what I will talk about, I will give you a little bit of insight into the history of this whole research exercise. Second, I will try to a glimpse on what is socio-ecological research. This is a new term. Social ecology is a new term. It's an interdisciplinary effort, and it's sort of becoming a research tradition also internationally, and how to do it on Samothraki. Then I will show you some of the work packages we are after, and the findings we have, and how to move on. And this is, we do this today because you will have, in your summer school, you will see only kind of narrow streams of research that has an overall sort of integrating model behind it. And it's all interconnected. And
so I think we did, thanks to this project and the initiative, we did a really, we set the foundation for a better future. Especially as Merula said, because people really saw with their eyes and understood the need, what's really happening, why we have trees here and we don't have there. And look, there we have fallen, all fallen trees, and then some there, and then there is no soil. Why there is no soil? Because there are no trees to hold the soil in place. And there, the situation now is irreversible. So we are at a tipping point, basically. What do we do?
We need large, small ruminant population with overgrazing and soil erosion, uncontrolled fresh water extraction, high dependence on imports and waste accumulation, highly concentrated tourist areas, which is a burden for infrastructure because in summertime it's being overused, in wintertime it's being
to be here and to share our ideas and some kind of experience here, because taxonomies are dying population.
So we try to introduce these biodiverse soil pastures, where we have a big proportion in the seed mix, which is a seed mix, and the big proportion is legumes that produce better, we have legumes and grasses. The legumes also produce a better quality food and also help the soil to protect it.
The rest of the module was devoted into the ecology and taxonomy of the Chironomidae, which are part of the Diptera order. Here are the sampling sites and some corresponding photos. This one does not actually correspond to this one, but for some reason this is not here.
You can see on this diagram here, the health is defined by some different factors. One of them is the vitality, that means how many dead branches are in the tree or in the trunk. And vitality code in this case is almost, with Carina style, is almost 100% one. That would mean that less than a third part of all the branches in the trunk are dead, which is a good vitality sign. With ours it was a little bit less, but still 80%.
Social metabolism, like social ecology, like our master studies, stems from natural science, kind of where
statistics about about the imports, the exports, what was extracted. So our goal was to close the data gaps we have through the interviews we did.
So an island is a local social system.